And welcome back to the channel. On this video, we're doing a night ride here to test out the headlight. As you see there, I don't want to get too direct on with it because it's pretty bright. We're gonna give it a try and see how it looks in action. And there's our tail light there. So let's hop aboard and see how well the headlight performs for us on the Lyric Graffiti. I'm hearing a rub. Let's see what that is. I think that noise you just heard as I take off was the fact that I pumped up the tires a little more. The recommended PSI is between 12 and 20, and I had them between 17 to 18, 17 and a half or something like that, I think it was. And so I pumped them up a little more because I thought they were a little bit soft, and so I pumped it up to 20, and I think that noise was a little rubbing on the fender at the back, so I just adjusted the fender, because the fenders on this bike do sit pretty close to the they're pretty close to the tire. There's not much space in between the fender and the tire, and these are metal fenders. Boy, this headlight, as you can see straight ahead here, is, look at that, you see the whole road. Where, as I'm going to use the Grizzly as an example, you don't get nothing like that. Yeah, this headlight is going to be great here. I don't do a lot of night riding, but I do a little, and so we all want good lighting when we're out riding, not only for ourselves, but so others can see us as well. That noise you just heard was me using the regen brake. Just before it stops, it makes that little bit of a noise there. It's a coolish evening here right now. I'm coming out here, I think the temperature when I looked was 29 degrees, so a little on the chilly side. But like I've been saying all the way along, every single time I get on this bike, I'm liking it more and more. This bike is just a joy to ride. And when you see somebody else riding on it, like I saw the reviews when they first were doing their little tour there, their promotional tour, and they went around and had some of the bigger YouTubers. Of course, ones that are a lot bigger than I am, I'm talking subscriber-wise anyway, do runs on their bike, test rides, and giving a quick review. It's not the same as you riding the bike. You know, when you get on there, you get to see for yourself what the bike can do. And I gotta be honest, when you ride a bike, it is kind of hard to do a review on a bike in just one day or 1 hour or whatever of riding. You can give like a quick review there, but it's not really the same as actually getting the bike and riding it for a month or so. You know, giving it a good try, you get a feel for the bike, you know exactly what the bike can do. When somebody just hops on a bike and rides it around, it's a little different. I mean it gives you an idea, and especially when that's all you have to go on, you know, is someone else's word and reading up on it and all of that. But it's just not the same as riding the bike and riding it on a daily basis. I mean, I put the Grizzly on the back burner right now because I want to ride this bike. It doesn't mean I'm not going to get the other bike out again or the Rad or any other bikes in my future that are coming up, but I just think the more you ride one, the more you can tell what it can do. And like I say, though, it's your opinion, though. Somebody else may see differently than you, even though you're riding the same bike. They might expect something different out of the bike. To me, I'll tell you, to be honest, this bike is doing more than I thought it would. It's been an absolute joy. And I think I'm liking the tires pumped up here to 20. I think we're getting a little better ride, to be honest with you. If I was on off-road rides more, then I might drop it back down. But I do, most of my riding is on roads, just like I am right now. So I like the tires pumped up a little more. This headlight is really great. Let's see here. Oops. Okay, so we can turn it right down to just the no headlight. And then we can turn it to low beam and high beam. I tend to leave mine on high beam. When I'm out like I am now, I want full light. I suppose if you're in a well-lit area and you've got cars coming at you, you don't want to blind your fellow folk out there. You know, you want to respect just as you hope that they respect you. And go down to the low beam. Yeah, this headlight, I think this headlight is about as good as you're ever going to get. I don't even know, you know, several folks, when they get their bike, that's one thing that quickly gets changed, right? Especially if you're doing night riding, is got to have a good headlight. So a lot of times the headlight will get swapped out as one of the very first things. But honestly, on this bike, there's a couple of things for sure, three things that a lot of times folks will swap out right away, pretty quick. One of them is the handlebars, one of them is the seat, and one of them is the headlight. Those three, there's more things, but those three come to mind really quick. And those are three things on this bike you don't have to swap out. And for me, I usually just like to leave the bike the way it is as I bought it. That's how I bought it. I bought it You know, the way it was sold to me, and I don't usually do any changes. I mean, I'll do a few things on here, not changing anything, I'll just add. I mean, I need a mirror at some point. I'm not too worried about that right now, but at some point I'm gonna get a mirror, and I would like the phone mount as well. But I'm not in a rush for those. I'm still just enjoying the riding around on this bike. Oh, this bike is just wonderful. Can't say enough about it. It's gonna be hard to beat this bike. If you ever do get a new bike, a second or a third bike, you're always wanting to one up your last bike, right? Or kind of, what's the point, right? You want to get better. You want the bike to do something that the other bike didn't do. And it's gonna be hard to beat this one. Not that I'm gonna try right now anyway, but we'll see what happens in the future. But the Headlight is definitely two thumbs up for me. I can't see anybody not liking this Headlight. I can't see anyone wanting to swap this out. I would have no idea why they would want to. So look at that. It's just, it's perfect. I mean, I could tilt it up a little bit more maybe, but I like it where I can see not too far in front of me, make sure I'm not running over anything, or although when you're going faster, it's kind of hard to avoid something last second, you know, your reaction time when it's that close and you're going that fast isn't going to be as great. Feels like a ghost town here. I get the road to myself. And you know, I gotta bring up the suspension thing again. This bike really surprises me as far as that goes. I mean, I thought the not having the rear suspension would bother me more, but in the kind of riding I do, I'm not going to miss that at all. I mean, it would be okay if it was there, but I think I'd rather have the regen braking than I would the full suspension. I'd rather have better tires, like good tires, I think, than a full like a rear suspension, especially on a bike like this that it rides smoothly without the rear suspension, to me anyway. And but good tires, I mean good tires as far as, I'd like some tires that would last a while, you know. I think the tires on this bike, I read the manual and they're suggesting 750 to 1200 miles, it sounds like, before you'll have to swap these out. That's pretty similar to the Grizzly and the stock tires that came on it. I think I did around 800 miles before they needed to be replaced. So I'm figuring it's probably going to be around that for this one as well. But the Headlight is definitely a winner. There's no reason why you need to swap this Headlight out for anything else, in my opinion. So that's going to do it for another video here on the channel. I want to mention too that if you'd like to purchase the Lyric Graffiti, I do have a link in my descriptions, and I have a discount code to get you $100 off the bike should you decide to purchase one, and that's Oregon E-Biker Mark. Put that in the after you click the link and go to the site, put that in the in there to get the $100 off, and that's Oregon E-Biker Mark, all one word. If you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button. If you'd like to subscribe to the channel, please do hit that subscribe button. And if you want to be notified as to when the next video comes up on the channel, just hit that notification bell and it'll activate it, and you'll know when the next video comes up on the channel. So once again, thank you for joining me today or tonight. And until next time. Take care.